do you think that we're innovating in the right direction? Are we developing the tools necessary, or who comes up with the ideas to develop these machines?
The big challenge here is there's really brilliant people in the United States as a whole, in the defense enterprise. I do think that there are many obstacles towards the U.S. innovating the way that I think we should be. One of them is that a lot of this technology is happening outside of the traditional defense sector. So it's happening out in places like Amazon and Google and Facebook and others. If you look at some of the artificial intelligence, that's where all the action is. It's not actually in defense companies. And it's a struggle bureaucratically to get these companies to want to work with the Defense Department. There are a lot of sort of self-imposed barriers that the Pentagon creates to making it hard for companies to work with them. But there are also some cultural issues. There was just a big flap a couple weeks ago where it came out publicly that Google had been working with the Pentagon on a Pentagon project called Project Maven that was being used to use artificial intelligence tools that Google's made to process drone video feeds. So one of the things that we could do with artificial intelligence is build object classifiers, image classifiers that can identify objects. And they can actually beat humans at benchmark sort of tests for this. So the idea is that you take these tools, you feed them into drone video feeds, and then they can sift through these sort of thousands of hours of video feeds to identify things of interest for people. They could say, instead of having a human stare at these drone feeds for hours on end, you could have this algorithm watch the drone feed, and if you know you're looking for, say, a certain type of vehicle, or a human comes out of this compound, it would alert the human. Watch for that. It's a good use of the technology. There was a big blow-up inside Google after this came out that this had happened. And eventually over 3,000 Google employees signed an open letter to their CEO saying, we don't support this. We don't want to do this. This is their own country, right? So I think, like, when you think about this, and this isn't like, the AI is not killing anyone. It's actually not being used for autonomous targeting. Humans are still in control. And this is being used to target terrorists that are trying to kill Americans. But you have such a cultural divide between Pentagon and the Silicon Valley that you have people saying, like, I just don't support this, I don't want to do this. I think it's really interesting when you think about this kind of historically. It's hard for me to imagine something like, you know, Ford Motor Company employees, you know, standing up during World War II and saying, like, we don't want to support, you know, Ford working with the US government. And yet that's I think one challenge. Another challenge is this valley of death I talked about. There are cultural challenges in importing this technology. So I do think it's a struggle to ensure the U.S. stays ahead. In particularly areas like artificial intelligence, others have made very clear they intend to take the lead in this space. China last year put out a national strategy for artificial intelligence. They are a major player in the space. Depending on who I talk to on the tech side, they will say either the Chinese are right behind U.S. companies, right equal, or sometimes I've heard some very knowledgeable people in tech companies say the Chinese are a little bit ahead. And China has said their goal is to be the global leader in artificial intelligence by 2030. And they have a plan to do that. And we don't have anything like that in the United States. We don't have a national plan. We don't have major R&D into this space. We don't have a plan for human capital, which is what really matters here. Things like STEM education or immigration policy. Right? In fact, we have an immigration policy coming out of the White House that actively discourages people from coming to the United States. Why would we do that? Right? We want the smartest people from the world to come here and stay here, right? Come to the US. That's one of our best advantages. So I do think that it's a big challenge. And I think that we've become accustomed for decades to a world where the US is the world's leader in technology. That is not a birthright. And we are in a technology race with others. And if we want to win that race, we've got to compete.